Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. Neural networks are so broadly used today for so many usages, from financial to security to image and speech understanding and more. We want these neural networks to run as fast as possible on as many as possible platforms. OneDNN is a key element to enable exactly that. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor, open spec libraries. One of them is oneDNN, the oneAPI deep neural network library. Many applications are already using oneDNN, so let's look at what is oneDNN and what is included. In the next video, we'll go into more detail, talk about the programming model, and look at a sample code. oneDNN is the evolution of what we used to call mkLDNN. It is cross-platform, meaning you can use the same function or primitive on totally different platforms, and it is performance library, mainly for deep learning applications, meaning it provides highly optimized implementation of deep learning building blocks. The focus is the building blocks, the lower level primitives functionality. You can see the current list of them here. It is not the oneDNN goal to provide end-to-end solution for implementation of neural networks. So it is possible that not all your primitives are implemented, but probably the most important ones, important for performance, are there. oneDNN is a great example for highly portable cross-platform library. You can find here primitives that have implementation for very different architectures like CPU, GPU, and others by various different vendors like ARM, AMD, or NVIDIA, using various ISA acceleration like AVX 512 on various formats like bfloats or integer. So the same library primitive can have many versions or implementations, and the library could be used by many tools. For example, Intel distribution of TensorFlow and PyTorch are using oneDNN for training. OpenVINO is using oneDNN for inference. That means that for most programmers, if you're using OpenVINO or the oneAPI AI toolkit, you're already enjoying the benefits and the acceleration provided by oneDNN. Or you can get the oneDNN binaries from the oneAPI base toolkit. Probably the best means of communication with the oneDNN team is via GitHub. Let's Google git oneDNN. And here you can find the open source code, submit issues, requests, or feedback. Explanations on oneDNN, supported platforms, how to install, and so on. And let's see the developer's guide. How to build, link, what is a programming model, and so on. And if you look at the API reference, you can find the list of supported primitives and more, each with the full description. Another place to go is oneAPI.com. Go to the spec, let's look at oneDNN, and you can find here the full specification of the library. In the next video, we'll dive a little deeper into the programming model and see a few examples. See you there. Thank you.